You can talk all you want, but my skin is really thick. I'm the leader of the crowd, and my game is really slick. I'm unstoppable, 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 unstoppable. You can talk.
Welcome to Mondays with me again. This week's topic is going to be discrimination.
Speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be.
Hey, we see it every day, all over the place. Everywhere we go, people fear what they don't understand, and that is the biggest problem with hate, is people spend too much time looking at something and seeing that it's different and out of what their normal comfort zone is, and immediately they go, whoa, that freaks me out, that scares me because it's not like me. I've been discriminated against just because I'm a lesbian. I've been called a tranny chaser because I choose to date transgendered individuals on occasion. I've been discriminated against because my mom dates a black guy for being white. I've been discriminated just because I was in a multiracial relationship for being Spanish. I've been discriminated against just for being a woman. I remember one day I was going to Pride in Boston by myself. And I was meeting up with my friends there because I had a show earlier. And I had a rainbow bag with me. Everything else about me, I was very feminine dressed, like long hair as usual. But I had a rainbow bag. And I was on the MTB, which is like the train, into Boston. And these guys basically came out of nowhere on the train and started harassing me. Like, why do you have a rainbow bag? Blah, 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 blah. Are you a dyke? Blah, 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 blah. And I was like, I'm a lesbian, I'm going to Pride, it's none of your business, please leave me alone. And I had to have the man next to me tell them to leave me alone, or that he would contact the conductor and get them off of the T, because they wouldn't stop harassing me. They were like, oh yeah, baby, I could turn you straight, all this stuff, you're not gay, you're too girly and pretty to be gay. I've had people get in my face for being gay. And then I went to Pride, and, If anyone's ever been to a Pride, who's watching this, which I'm assuming people have, you see people with picket signs everywhere basically saying that we're abominations and that who we love is wrong and that a man and a woman equals marriage, and then like pictures of a woman don't equal marriage and a man don't equal marriage. And I don't know what to do about it. Like, I want so badly to hate those people, but I know that if I just hate them, I'm gonna fuel the fire of discrimination, and instead of hating them, I feel bad for them. I feel bad for them because to live a life that's filled with fear of others and dedicating your life to hatred must be a pretty lonely life. Sorry, I just had a wicked bad brain fart. One of the things that we're supposed to cover is how discrimination affects other people, and we see the effects of discrimination every single day of our lives. I mean, war, death, as in murder, suicide is a big one, just in everyday life. Do you know how many people stay inside the closet just because of discrimination and because they're afraid to be who they are? That's why when people get, like, have you ever heard the cases where people get married and then all of a sudden, like, years later, the husband or wife comes out of the closet, finally unable to deal with the fact that they've built this whole entire lie around their life? That not only affects the person who is coming out, but it affects the family that they've created in a very, very, very powerful way. And it's all because of the discrimination and fear of who you are that things like that happen. I'm actually doing work right now about helping in homeless shelters and in my peace and justice degree that I'm trying to get. And the amount of children and young adults who are homeless because they've been cast out of their homes all because they are gay or transgendered, the number is completely and totally ridiculous for how many people are homeless just because of that. I was actually in the show, The Laramie Project, which is about the murder and torture of Matthew Shepard. It was a hate crime where he was at a bar and these two men thought that he was hitting on them. So they decided to mess with him and he got pretty drunk and they offered to give him a ride home. They ended up taking him out to the middle of the field, stripping him naked, tying him to a crossbuck fence, and along with burning his genitals and mutilating him and hitting him over the head with the back of a butt of a gun, they left him out there to die and to bleed to death. And he was found by a runner. And one of the most touching parts of that whole thing was when the officer says the only thing on him that wasn't covered in blood were the two trails of tears down his face. And in that show, we had to find a hate crime victim that we could relate to. And at the end of the show, we had candles and we said their name and why they were killed and what day they were killed and then blew out their candle. And as I looked through all of these hate crime victims, people are killed over the stupidest shit. Discrimination to me is like gasoline or oil. If it gets somewhere and it gets in on someone, on anything, all it takes is one match to light up a very, very dangerous fire. And that's what discrimination is. Basically, someone takes their ideas, shows it to someone else, and if you're weak-minded enough, you take that with you and think, well, they think that, so I should think that. And that's what it all comes down to, is a stigma of fear that is passed on through the generations. Now, we're supposed to... apparently, I don't know how to talk, but anyways, a way for us to stop hatred and discrimination is by not discriminating yourself. And I want to stress that. It's really easy to say, oh, discrimination is bad, but still discriminate yourself. Whether someone is gay, straight, bisexual, transgendered, black, white, Asian, anything else that you can possibly think of, Indian, whatever you want, no matter what, Arab, like, no matter what, people are people, and at the end of the day, we all bleed the same blood. A really good video that you should look up is from Between Us Boys, and Boys is spelled with B-O-I-S, and it's a group that I know, and they have a performance called Spectrum. And what they stress is that not everyone looks the same, not everyone is the same, but we all are on the same spectrum together. We're all human beings, no matter what. And no matter how different we may look or our lifestyles may be, we're all the same people. And at the end of the day, we're all still mortal and we're all still of the same species and we should be together. Imagine what we could do with the world if all of us just put aside our differences and just said, if we all got along, the world would be 10 times better. We'd be 10 times more powerful and 10 times more safe. So the next time someone discriminates against you or causes you problems, instead of almost firing back in a angry way, of course, like, stick up for yourself, but instead of maybe firing back with hatred, try to look at it from the other side, because as cheesy as it sounds, you can fight hate with love. Instead of looking at that person being like, oh, screw them, maybe educate them, maybe help them see that you're not as bad as they thought you were. Fight fire with water, not fire. Try to put it out, extinguish it, and educate. That's what we're doing on here, educating others. And discrimination will never go away. I'm sorry, it won't. Everyone is afraid of what they don't understand, but fighting discrimination with discrimination and just hating on other people because they don't like you, it just brings you down to their level. So understand that not everyone can be as open-minded, and that just live your life and just try not to let it get to you, because you know who you are, the people who love you know who you are, and it is what it is. They don't matter. Me, personally, I don't really care what anyone thinks of me. You can attack my looks, my sexuality, my age, anything about me, external or internal, and I really could give less of a shit what you think. But not everyone's the same. Discrimination does hurt everyone. So stop discrimination and think before you speak and think before your actions. And that's all I ask. So see you next week, guys.